Hi, I'm Steve Hodges. I'm a pediatric urologist at Wake Forest Baptist Health. I got into pediatric urology mainly because I really enjoy taking care of kids. Kids are, they're the best patients. They're very optimistic. They're so enthusiastic to get out of the hospital and get better, and they do so well. I also like the reconstructive aspects, which includes a lot of plastic surgery involved in pediatric urology. I've got a couple areas of interest in my research. I'm really interested in urethral stricture disease, which is a narrowing in the bladder outlet that can be treated with some drugs that we've identified, and also really interested in toilet training. You know, a lot of these questions haven't been answered. When should you toilet train a child? How should you toilet train a child? What causes bedwetting, daytime wetting? One of the neat areas that we've been looking at in my clinic is bedwetting. Kids come in with bedwetting all the time. They have three basic causes that people think cause bedwetting. Children don't wake up at night very easily. Children make too much urine at night, and the bladder capacity is small. I see all the failings all the time. Parents try to set alarms to try to wake up the children. They're still wet. Parents try to take them out of pull-ups or so they'll feel the wetness. It doesn't work. Pediatricians oftentimes kind of reflexively just prescribe medicines to relax a bladder or to prevent urine output at night, and those all fail. So in our clinic, we found a couple kids that were really bad bedwetters that kind of serendipitously we had performed x-rays on. We found that had large amounts of constipation, even though the parents didn't think they had any problems at all pooping. She said, oh, this is neat. Maybe this has something to do with it. So we did 50 more kids. They all were full of poop, all constipated. I thought I had made this great discovery. So I went to write this all up, that treating this occult or hidden constipation treats bedwetting. It does almost every time. And as I was pulling the papers to write this manuscript, I found that the research had already been done in the 80s. But completely misunderstood and lost basically to history in the past 30 years. It's unbelievable. We tracked down the doctor that done the research. He was in Canada at the time. Now he's in Arizona. And he confirmed it. And he actually treated all his children with bedwetting with enemas just to adjust the constipation, which we don't do except in select cases. And he had almost 100% success rate, way better than any of the recent papers. And we've actually done a study on that, had good success with laxatives and bedwetters, and recently had a paper accepted for publication in one of the urology journals.